Hello there, guys, and this time I will be starting a new series called Paleo Profile. In this series, I will examine the lesser known, yet still very interesting, creatures that once walked this earth. From the microorganisms that dwelled on earth when it was covered completely in ice, to giant carnivorous birds that preyed on the ancestor of horses. Yeah, that's a thing that existed. I guess I sort of already started this series with my previous video talking about Spinosaurus. So, yeah. Today we will be examining another dinosaur. If you were to ask me what my favorite dinosaur would be, I would tell you, of course, Spinosaurus, due to its strangeness and pure size. If you were to ask me what my second favorite dinosaur was, I would tell you Utahraptor, because of its size and pure brutality. If I were to tell you what my third favorite dinosaur is, I would of course tell you Yutyrannus. Simply put, because of feathers. Today, we will examine the feathered tyrant, Yutyrannus. For the longest time, paleontologists speculated a large amount of dinosaurs had feathers, most feathered dinosaurs being relatives of raptors and therizinosaurus, leaving everybody's favorite dinosaurs like T-Rex and other tyrannosaurs scaly and relatively far from feathered. However, that all changed at Easter time, 2012, with the discovery of Yutyrannus, which I guess means this is an Easter episode? Sure, why not? Makes as much sense as my Valentine's Day episode. Anyways, all you need to know is that the importance of the discovery of Yutyrannus is that it dramatically increased the size range of dinosaurs for which we have definite evidence of feathers on. Yutyrannus, meaning feathered tyrant, is a genus of tyrannosaurid dinosaurs, a group of dinosaurs that includes T-Rex. It existed during the early Cretaceous period, about 124 million years ago, and lived in what is now northeastern China. Yutyrannus was discovered in 2012, and is known from three nearly complete fossil specimens, an adult, a teenager, and a juvenile, acquired from a fossil dealer who claimed all three were found in a single quarry, suggesting Yutyrannus lived in small family groups. Yutyrannus is currently the largest known species of dinosaur with direct evidence of feathers. The oldest known and largest specimen having a length of 9 meters, or 30 feet, and an estimated weight about 1,414 kilograms, or 3,117 pounds, 40 times heavier than the previous record holder,
the Bipalosaurus.
Yeah, what he said, which funny enough had actually been found in the same area as Yutyrannus. The feathers of our Tyrannosaur were long, about 8 inches, and were a lot more like fuzz covering than feathers of modern birds. These fur-like feathers covered various parts of the body. In one specimen, they were present on the pelvis and the foot. Another specimen had feathers on the tail pointing backwards. And the smallest specimen showed 8-inch-long feathers on the neck and 6-inch-long feathers on the upper arm. Based on the various placements of these feathers, they may have covered the whole body of Yutyrannus and served in regulating temperature, given the rather cold climate of Yutyrannus' environment, which had an average of annual temperature of 10 degrees Celsius, or 50 degrees Fahrenheit. With this evidence, Yutyrannus was the prehistoric dinosaur equivalent of a bear, living in cold environments and hunting on the available prey. Yutyrannus' feathers have been featured two ways, dull and unattractive, only being used for warmth, and bright and flamboyant, being used to attract mates. Neither of these ideas can be completely confirmed, though. The color of Yutyrannus' feathers and the actual use for them is merely speculation, but most scientists seem to agree they were primarily used to keep the dinosaur warm in its chilling cold environment, like the hair on mammals. As said before, Yutyrannus is a tyrannosaur, a close cousin to such dinosaurs as the Tyrannosaurus and Gorgosaurus. The presence of feathers on large tyrannosaur ancestors suggests that the possibility that later tyrannosaurs were also feathered. However, scaly skin impressions have been reported from various late Cretaceous tyrannosaurs, such as Gorgosaurus and Tyrannosaurus, on parts of the body where Yutyrannus was feathered. Paleontologists are led to the conclusion that T-Rex and other tyrannosaurs most likely had small amounts of feathers on their bodies, but these feathers did not cover the whole body, unlike in Yutyrannus. Late Cretaceous tyrannosaurs lived in a much hotter environment compared to Yutyrannus. Picture Yutyrannus being a woolly mammoth and T-Rex being an elephant. That's probably how the feathers of Yutyrannus compared to the feathers of T-Rex and others. One animal was completely covered in them, and the other having very small amounts of them. Yutyrannus is a very interesting dinosaur, as it has transformed how we look at other dinosaurs. No longer is T-Rex completely excused from being naked and scaly all over. Unfortunately, Yutyrannus has only been featured once in pop culture due to its very recent discovery, only appearing in the video game Jurassic Park Builder, as a limited edition dinosaur, featured with both the flamboyant feathers and the dull feathers. Also, Yutyrannus is currently the only dinosaur in Jurassic Park Builder to have feathers. Well, that's all the time we have for this Paleo Profile. Thanks for watching, and look out for the next episode, which will be about this peculiar creature. Whoever can guess what it is first will get his or her name featured in the next episode. So like, favorite, subscribe for more things prehistoric. I'm the Explainer, and I'll see you later.